nights ago I saw you. I looked up when you came through the door. My head started reeling, you gave me the feeling the room had no ceiling or floor. 10 minutes ago I met you, and we murmured our how do you do's. I wanted to ring out the bells and fling out my arms and to sing out the news. I have found her, she's an angel with the dust of the stars in her eyes. We are dancing, we are flying, and she's taking me back to the skies. In the arms of my love I'm flying, over mountain and meadow and glen. And I like it so well that for all I can tell I may never come down again. I may never come down to earth again.
We are flying,
and she's taking me back to the skies.
In the arms of my love I'm flying, over mountain and meadow and glen.
And I like it so well that for all I can tell I may never come down again. I may never come down to earth again. Thank you.
Once upon a time, there was a man who was rich in spirit and in wealth. As fate would have it, his wife fell ill before her time. As her end was drawing near, she called her only daughter to her bedside and said, "Dear child, be good and pious, and then I shall forever look down upon and be near thee." Thereupon she closed her eyes and departed. It happened that the rich man took himself another wife, but he soon departed from his house, for his business affairs required that he travel to faraway lands. The woman had brought three daughters into the house with her. Now these daughters were vile and black of heart, and thus began a bad time for the poor stepchild. "Is that stupid goose going to sit in the parlor with us?" they said. "She who wants to eat bread must earn it. Out with the kitchen wench." They took away her pretty clothes and dressed her in rags. "Just look at the proud princess, how decked she is," they cried and laughed, and led her to the kitchen to be treated no better than a slave. There she had to do hard work from morning to night, get up before daybreak, carry water, light fires, cook and wash. Besides this, the sisters did her every imaginable injury. She had no bed to go to at night, and had to sleep by the ashes in the fireside. And as on that account, she always looked dusty and dirty, they called her Cinderella.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.